Hello everyone, in this video lecture we will study the concept of universal Turing machine and Church Turing thesis. So let us discuss universal Turing machine first. Here we will see what it does and why we need this. So name itself suggests it's a universal Turing machine. So it's a Turing machine for all other Turing machines that we have. Now question is that can we have any algorithm which will tell us if a given Turing machine accepts a given string? So to understand that, let us take an example. So we have the language A subscript of Tm, M comma W, where M is Turing machine and M accepts the string W. Is Turing recognizable. So this language ATM has two elements. First one is M, that is the Turing machine, and W is the string. If we pass into the Turing machine, M will be accepted. So if we have string W, which we will pass to this Turing machine, M is accepted, then we can say this whole thing is lies into the language ATM, and we can say this language is Turing recognizable. Now if we change the string W, then Turing machine M may accept this string, sometime may reject this string, or sometime it goes into the loop. So we can say it is the Turing recognizable but not the decidable. Now given description of a Turing machine and some input string, can we decide the machine accepts it? So here is the role of universal Turing machine comes into play. So in universal Turing machine, we can pass the description of other Turing machine and some input. So pass description of another Turing machine along with some value of string to universal Turing machine and then run it. Now universal Turing machine will behave exactly like other Turing machine that we have. So here is the possible results. So if the Turing machine M that we have accepts the W, then our universal Turing machine will halt and accept. If M rejects W, then our algorithm, that means our universal Turing machine, will halt and reject. If M loop on W, then our algorithm will not halt. So universal Turing machine will exactly behave same as Turing machine M that we have passed to it. In short, we will pass Turing machine M an input string W to universal Turing machine, and we will see how universal Turing machine behaves. So we know that how the universal Turing machine behaves. It behaves exactly same as how the M is supposed to behave. So here are some of the options. It could either halt and accept, or halt and reject, or sometime it may not halt. Now let us see what is the input and action we can have in Turing machine. So input of universal Turing machine is the description of another Turing machine M and input string of M. So this two will be passed to the universal Turing machine, and the action that can be carried out by the Turing machine is, first one is simulate the M, and second one is it behaves just like M. So sometimes it may accept, sometimes it may reject, or sometimes it may loop. To understand universal Turing machine in better way, let us compare our universal Turing machine with a general purpose computer. We know very well what is the general purpose computer do. In our general purpose computer, we write our program and then our computer will help us to run that program. For example, we have written a program of to check whether given number is prime or not in some of the programming language. So consider your program is first Turing machine M, then put your program in your computer, then computer run your program, and it will give us the output based on the input you have given. So here your program is some Turing machine M and your computer is universal Turing machine. I hope now concept of universal Turing machine is clear. So in last, we can say universal Turing machine is recognizer for the language A subscript of TM, MW, where M is Turing machine and W is string of M. So for this language, universal Turing machine is recognizer. It is recognizer because sometimes it may accept, it may sometimes reject, and it may sometimes look depending upon the Turing machine and the input. So this is the concept of universal Turing machine and how it works. I hope it is clear. Now let us discuss Church-Turing thesis. Church-Turing thesis is come from the question, what does the computable mean? In old days, term computable was actually fuzzy. We cannot give proper definition in order to define what does computable mean. Meaning of term computable was given by one American mathematician, Alonzo Church. He came up with the idea of lambda calculus. So lambda calculus was a kind of machine that could perform some computation. So whatever can be calculated by lambda calculus, that is called computable. And later on, another computer scientist, Alan Turing, came up with the concept of Turing machine. So Turing machine is again another kind of computation model that is used to perform some computation. So both of these people come up with the idea of lambda calculus and Turing machine, and then said that whatever the computable by this machine, that is what we can call is computable. Turing machine and lambda calculus is equivalent in power, though they work in different ways, but they are equivalent in power. But actually, we don't use lambda calculus as a benchmark to standardize the computable term, but we use the Turing machine. So we can say that algorithmically computable means computable by Turing machine. If anything can be computed using algorithm, that means it can be computed by Turing machine. So any algorithmic procedure that can be carried out at all by any human computer or team of humans or electronics computer can be carried out by Turing machine. This statement usually referred as Church-Turing thesis. Here is an informal summary of some of the evidence. Human normally works with two-dimensional sheet of paper. A Turing machine tab can be organized so as simulate two dimensions. One likely consequence would be that Turing machine requires more move to do what the humans would do in one. Various enhancement of Turing machine, for example, multi-tab Turing machine. Other theoretical model includes abstract machine with two state or with a queue. Since the introduction of Turing machine, no one has suggested any type of computation that ought to be included in the category of algorithmic procedure and cannot be implemented on Turing machine. So these are some of the evidence for Church-Turing thesis. I hope it is clear. Thank you all of you.